Okay, so we now let's talk a little bit about the Salarians next steps. Place on the Nexus.
We came to Andromeda because we had a contribution to make. The Ket won't take that away.
So of course we've now successfully finished that mission in which we fought the got the information from the Archon. We didn't really fight him specifically per se, but the Archon's map shows the way to Meridian, the super vault unlocker thingy. However, this issue affects the entire Andromeda Initiative, and leadership should be consulted before proceeding. So we can speak to the leaders of the Nexus. However, on the other hand, I mean, it might make sense to do that just to sort of conclude this thread. I guess I'm not, well, no, the fact that this is under a new name, a new category, the Journey to Meridian. Rather than this being this kind of a transition between the whole stuff with raiding the Archon ship and now moving on to the Meridian, but it looks like this is the first of what will be a many-step process to get to the Meridian. So I think for that reason, maybe we do hold off on this for the time being, because we do have at least one very high-priority thing that we want to do, if not more, because we've not yet been to H047C. So, because this is just a humongous question mark, we know that Vetra's loyalty mission is here, but beyond that, we know basically nothing about it. There are reports of interesting and potentially lucrative activity in the Remap system. While those reports alone seem vague, it's also the area that the Turian Arc may have been headed. Vetra and PB suggest that we check it out. So, we know next to nothing about this planet, and therefore there may be some important and time-sensitive things here that we just don't even have on our radar at the moment. So that is potentially something that is worth seeing to very quickly. The other thing that we do know definitively we must address quickly is, let's see which one it is, to keep Morta from potentially building a bomb. Retrieve the drive core located inside the heart of the Remnant derelict. We need to get it before her people do. Very clearly, a time sensitivity to that. So, part of me wants to go to this first because we know that this is sensitive. On the other hand, part of me wants to go to H47C because there may be things of equal importance and time sensitiveness, but we have no idea. So I think we might do this. Poke our head in, try to just get a bit of a lay of the land quickly. Maybe not get all caught up in doing a whole bunch of things here just yet, not unless we find something that is very obviously something that we should do very quickly. Then, once we've gathered that intel, we head over back to Elladin and make sure that the Krogan don't get that bomb. That's what I'm thinking. Okay. So, the other thing is that we did now just reach level 40, didn't we? So now, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, those lights supposed to be doing that? I believe, if I'm not mistaken, that was the threshold for now getting the next level of stuff. So let's just check real quick for, in particular, crafted weapons that we've created are the Hurricane. Yes, we can do that now. Level 50 is the next level. Okay. So not that this is going to be a huge difference maker. In fact, maybe not enough so for us to even bother investing in making this upgrade just yet. At least when it comes to spending the actual crafting materials. But for the research, that is definitely something that we want to get in here, I suppose. Basically, all the ones that we've already invested in thus far. Just get that next level. Before we forget, and, you know, you could make the case to upgrade your weapons every single level that you can. When it comes to the crafting, and maybe we have enough resources that that's not out of the question. But at the same time, it does feel like if we make a habit of doing that, then we could end up blowing through our resources quite quickly, even if we have done a lot to stockpile them thus far. So maybe it's not an every single level kind of thing, but more of a every other level kind of thing. Can we add mods to the Asari sword at all? To the melee weapons? Is that a thing? I don't remember. Because these do drop, or melee weapons in general, do drop sometimes from the Apex missions, and that way we might just end up getting ourselves a free Asari sword 6 and not even worth investing, otherwise we could, but okay. Let's leave it at that by the looks of things. Sandstorm, I don't really think we were trying to invest into that so much. That was just a one-off quest that we were doing that for. So yeah, we could craft an upgrade for it, but I think that may also get a little bit tedious if we're doing it every single level. Alright, so let's head over. Let us... Ooh, that is a dramatic look at the Solarian Arc. So it is really tempting to head back to the Nexus. I assume that's where the other quest is at the Nexus, where we're actually supposed to... Okay, hold on a second. Let's just check where the other quest is trying to take us. I assume... I mean, it says speak to the leaders of the Nexus. I assume that's on the Nexus and not just a video call. Because... we can do this. Let's at least do the main quest component. Usually the main quest component on other planets is relatively quick. At least it was in the most recent one on Elladin. And then, you know, just how long we stay will of course depend based on how many important things we find ourselves running into. So like, for example, I don't think we'll do Vetra's loyalty mission just yet. Just want to go over here, see what the planet is all about, see if there's anything that's really high priority, and if so, tackle that. If not, that just gives us peace of mind that we aren't missing anything really big, and then we head back to Elladin and make sure that the Krogan can't use the bomb.
Look at these readings. This system is beautiful.
I'll say that's a stellar nursery. Stars are born out here.
Okay, nothing to scan. So we'll finish with H047C. It's actually very far out there. I'm surprised it would be hot enough to colonize it. If it's that far away from the star. Alright, so we're now in the Remav system, I think. Phaedra, which has relatively thick atmosphere, very hot, despite being the furthest planet from the star, in part because of that. It's not thick enough that you'd think that'd be happening, but alas, the ruins of several Angaran exploratory missions dot Phaedra's surface, crushed by the planet's powerful gravity and half buried by its winds. Alright, nothing important for us to scan there, though. So again, we'll skip over that for the moment, but that is, of course, where we will end. Look at that. Moon in the back. That is a very large moon. Alright. A May. No atmosphere at all, and yet it is still scorching hot. At this point, I guess we're much closer because we did skip one planet. So, the part that is facing the star would be quite hot. This barren moon, this is a moon, is more scientifically interesting than its planet. Oh, this is the moon. That's the planet. Interesting. More scientifically interesting than its planet Ameyono, owing to traces of element zero detectable from... I mean, if we're going to get element zero from this, then I'm all for it.
Probes launched. We've got a crater.
I mean, well, it's a crater. Mineral deposits, it says element zero. This ancient impact crater contains traces of radioactive material, element zero, and metals not found naturally on the planet. Ah, it's just experience, darn. Ezo is ultra rare, so I was hoping we were going to get that. But alas, we did not. Noondri.
Anomaly detected.
Is that lava? Let's see. About one Earth atmosphere worth of atmospheric pressure, but it is very hot. The cracked surface contains large deposits of magnesium and cobalt. Constant volcanic activity. Okay, yep. Fuels streams of lava that glimmers from orbit. Those must be ginormous streams of lava if they are visible from orbit. It's gotta be this, right? No? This little redmost dot?
Probe away. Getting a scan.
It is a volcano. I mean, sounds from the description as if there would be many volcanoes here, but it is a stratovolcano with current explosive eruption, lava composition, and desite? I don't know how to say that word. Flow with unknown materials. Nundri is no stranger to eruptions, but this particularly massive explosion may offer a special insight into the planet's geology, giving us some experience. Okay. All right. And that means there is only one other planet for us to head over to, and it is the one that I really hope gets renamed at some point, because it is kind of obnoxious referring to it as H047C. That's not the planet, or is it? Wait, what? Hold on. What is it? Actually not a full-blown planet, it's just an asteroid? Can we land here? That would explain why it has a weird name. Hold on. Tiny little atmosphere, extremely cold. Shattered by the scourge, this formerly viable planet is now a debris field. Due to a lack of atmosphere, few life forms are present. Alert, excessive solar and cosmic radiation detected. Confinement to Nomad advised. There'll definitely be a hazard here, and probably a strong one at that. Let's see, the minerals. I don't know if any of those are ultra rare. Platinum is rare, at least, I think. Then we have the main quest mission, and then Vetra's Loyalty Mission. As I said, I think we will probably skip out on Vetra's Loyalty Mission for the time being. And just kind of mainline the main quest on this planet, or asteroid, slash do whatever other big things seem to be here. It's mostly a scouting mission. This may be a good way to phrase it. Okay, as for the squad we're bringing here. On one hand, there's a strong case to be made for bringing Vetra, because at some point in time, we're going to take her to do her loyalty mission here. On the other hand, I think we are going to do that on a future occasion, probably not right now. So, for that reason, perhaps we deliberately take someone other than Vetra. Like, who has it been? PB... We had a while where we did specifically PB plus Korra. Feels like those are the two we've had the longest without using, but maybe Korra specifically. And then Drac. We swap you out. We did reject Jahl previously. I mean, if it's a quick one, if it's a quick pit stop, maybe this is a chance to give Liam a little bit of time to shine, even if he's not usually one of our go-to people. In which case, we're going for a bit of a throwback here with both of our human squad mates. And I'm assuming this is going to be a pretty small location since it is an asteroid, but then again, of course, in general, we are only exploring a subset. It's not as if we're traversing an entire planet, even when we are on bigger planets than the, you know, actual planets. So, I don't know if that's actually gonna affect how large this area is. But we're about to find out.
Wow. Look at all this. The Scourge did a number here, didn't it? To think this was supposed to be the Turian home, now the exiles have taken over.
Cosmic radiation is off the charts, Ryder. You'll need to stay in the Nomad.
What good are these fancy suits if they don't block radiation?
In normal situations, they do. This planet's magnetic field was disrupted when it cracked open. No protection from a cosmic ray tearing you apart at the molecular level.
That sounds fun.
So, stick to the Nomad.
Descent engine engaged. Good luck, Ryder.
You know that there's something we're gonna do, right? You absolutely know the first thing we're going to do. New upgrades installed on the Nomad. Improved suspension. Oh, right. Oh, have we really not used the Nomad since we purchased a bunch of upgrades? I guess not. We should see a bunch of these pop up.
So, Kura. Asari Commandos. I hear a lot of things.
Oh, no.
You hear or you watch low-budget action vids?
Either way, Huntresses hunt. They sabotage. They do assassinations.
All officially sanctioned.
And that was all fine with you?
Yeah. Hunt down anti-Citadel fanatics, or let Crisis Response mop up the blood later. That's not a choice.
More about those Asari. But as I said, you know the first thing we're gonna have to do here.
Exposure to the surface
what?
Radiation will kill you, possibly.
No!
I do not advise leaving the Nomad.
Don't even let me leave the Nomad! What the heck? I wanted to leave the Nomad. It's only a level 1 radiation. It's not that bad. Come on. It can't be that bad. It's just level 1. All right, let's see. So, hold on. Can we get a sense for how big this... Well, this place is... I mean, the number of forward stations is certainly smaller than we'd get on other locations. We do also... Go here. Yeah. We have all those meters for the planets. I mean, this was once a planet, yes, but we're going to call it an asteroid for simplicity's sake. There's no viability meter here for this asteroid. Granted, I guess it's a pretty safe bet that they're not really going to try to recolonize this or colonize this place anymore. So, it's not as much incentive to explore around here. There's a rock here that we can hit. A question mark. There's also just way less stuff. What is the... Oh. Well, apparently we finished the main quest here. we just need to visit it. Alright, well, I mean, like I said, this is why we came here. Just to see what the whole deal about this place was. Guess we could head over here and see. We'll get the rock and see what the question mark is. Get a better sense of scale about how big this place actually is. Oh, lower gravity.
Gravity's lower than we're used to, Pathfinder. Gil says you shouldn't worry about accidentally hitting escape velocity.
You can do it on purpose.
Oh, I want to.
Ryder, tell me you're not. But Gil...
So cute when she's worried.
Oh, I mean, now I want to try. Okay, that was not the one all the way over here, I was going to say. If so, then goodness gracious, this place is absolutely tiny. But... Whoa, okay. Interesting. What is this that we see here? Also, it said that there were resources on this planet. I don't know how we can scan them, though. This is also our first time having upgraded the... Nomad,
Sam,
but it's kind of hard to compare it in a controlled experiment since this is
you should be able to
low grav.
Nomad once inside.
What about the crazy space radiation?
The dome structure prevents cosmic rays from entering.
Convenient.
You can drive into the airlock, Pathfinder.
So, is this going to be the... Let's just double check. Is this going to be the location where we initiate... Korra's loyalty mission? Because... Allies and relationships. Oh. So it really looks like that's gonna be the case. Oh, no. I mean, this does... Did Sam not just say this was a mining facility? So my point is, I don't want to do Vetra's loyalty mission right now. Obviously, we don't have Vetra with us, so it should prevent us from doing it anyway. So suppose we can poke her head in here and still see what it's all about. What the? Okay, that's not the way that I thought that was going to work, though. And also, there are apparently enemies here.
There's
also...
Heads up.
Hold on. There's Nickel. So this is where the... Oh, hello! where the stuff is. Anarchus? I would like to immediately activate this before we die. Wow! We are dead as soon as our cloak deactivates. Oh my god! Wow! These guys are no joke. I mean, granted, they've absolutely cornered us from every possible angle. So I think just running around in the middle like this is not the answer. Probably trying to jump up to some of these things we're seeing in the background there. But, okay. I was not even sure there were going to be enemies here at all. At first I was wondering if this was going to be, you know, the one peaceful location in this area where, you know, it'd be like a city of sorts. But apparently not.
Exiles, heads up.
How are you? How are they damaging us so quickly?
An undocumented mineral has been
I did not mean to do that. I didn't. We're gonna die again. Pariah? So, I mean, it's hard to tell with the human enemies which ones are more significant than others, because they all look very similar. I mean, obviously, to a certain extent, you can tell from, you know, do they have additional layers of defenses, like shields and what have you, and armor, but at a first glance, it's harder to tell. Like, obviously, Raider, I assume, is the weakest, but for that reason, when we are still inexperienced when it comes to facing these types of enemies, it's harder to tell just how significant of a force we're facing.
Exiles everywhere. What would they want with this place?
Pathfinder, I detect a data pad nearby. It may provide answers.
Okay. So yeah, here I was thinking, oh, maybe we'll just walk in, we'll chat with the locals and do some trade and what have you. No. No. Definitely not. But also, might I interest you in some nickel? Might I interest you in a wee bit of nickel? Just asking for a friend. Okay. Say there's a data pad. Also, there are things to scan, and I did not even see what that was. Exile Rock Runner? That's a cool name for it. According to the toxins present, this vehicle was transported from Kadara. It does seem like there are certainly some similarities to the situation on Kadara. There was the special rock, which was sort of, kind of, one of the original reasons why we came in here. Also a data pad here, apparently, somewhere. Sword shank, used for storing, I did not see what type of intel it gave us, I assume it was probably Milky Way. Used for storing helium-3 rich soil, is approximately one third full. Soil that is helium-3 rich? What? That's weird. Just a tech node. Yeah, it's all giving us Milky Way. Concentration sensor. Expensive device is used to detect the depth of helium-3 soil in a given area. The exiles have stolen it from the initiative. Helium-3 is usually in gas form. Isn't helium... Doesn't helium have the... what would it be? The lowest? Or, is what direction we're talking. It is the hardest to put it in the simplest of terms. Helium has to be really freaking cold to be a liquid, let alone a solid. I thought of all the elements, is this the rock in question? No, I don't think so. I thought of all the elements in the periodic table that it was the most difficult. As in, it had to be the coldest. to turn into liquid and solid form. So, unless this soil has a lot of helium-3 gas in it, something pretty funky is going on if they have solid helium-3 in the soil, is what I'm getting at. But perhaps any chemist could confirm for us. That was dramatic music as soon as we walked in here. And obviously this looks like a quite significant room. Hey, bum. Don't think flying off this butt end of nowhere will save you. You still owe me 80K, and you're going to make good. I have to cart myself over to that broken dump and shake the credits out of you myself. I will. You better be making a haul over there, because when you come back, you've got me to answer to. Hey, you left without saying goodbye. You're coming back, right? Did I do something? One second you're telling me I'm the guy for you, we should settle down, try and make the best of Katara. The next? Okay, forget it. You take all the time you need over there. Make your big score like you wanted, then you come back. I'm not going anywhere. I'll be here. Waiting. Do not respond. Automated receipt. Thank you for your purchase. Items. Asari Melding. Part 5. Quantity 1. Subtotal 50 credits. Convenience fee 2 credits. Platinum members discount minus 3 credits. Total 49 credits. If you have an issue with your purchase, please contact our customer service extranet address. Do not respond to this message. Okay, that is the data pad in question, but what is this? Oh, just a place where we can change our loadout? Okay, I'm not sure. Have we ever seen that on a planet outside of a forward station? Alright, what is this? Message for Alvis? Alvis Dumbledore? Got plenty of helium-3 soil at this site, but I think we'll deplete it pretty quickly. Once we finish here, head back to the base. Krex, we'll add it to the stash. In case you didn't get the new passcode, it's almost that, except part of the data got corrupted.
They're mining helium-3?
The main component in shuttle fuel Pathfinder.
Yes.
It can also be used to make highly effective explosives.
Ah.
Just what we need. Exiles with explosives. Let's get into that base.
The attached passcode is only a fragment. Data here indicates other mining domes. I added the locations to your map.
Okay, so do we take that to mean that both the Krogan and these, what are we calling them? Exiles? Bandits? Both of them are trying to create bombs to blow up the Nexus? Like, fine. I'll take it that there are multiple groups trying to cause harm to the Nexus, but it's like, come up with your own strategy, dude. Sorry, the Krogan beat you to it. Find some other way to mess with the initiative. Just be more creative with your sabotage. And I was kind of expecting for there to be some sort of tunnel or something like that that would connect this area to another dome. What is that? It's, oh, that's the spot where we can swap around our loadout. That's what that icon is for. Okay, so I think we're done here in that case. So yeah, not exactly what I expected to see here.
Ever disobeyed an order?
That data pad we found mentioned a guy named Krax. Any idea who that is?
Beats me. He doesn't come up in any records.
Also, there may be mining zones around here, that would make sense. Okay, so the planet does seem small, or the planet asteroid. I mean, that it does let us scroll further into the corners here. well beyond where any of the forward stations are. I feel like there's going to be some invisible walls that are functionally making the area smaller still than that. There's two things of interest here. Oh, code and rock. Did we find the rock here? I thought that was originally one of the things that brought us here. I guess we did? Okay, so assuming that the bomb that they are trying to create here is also intended to sabotage the Nexus, I guess we take that to mean that this is very similar to the bomb that the Krogan are trying to make, and therefore also something that we need to address quickly. Otherwise, they may be able to create it before we have the chance to stop them. So I think for that reason, we probably do stick around and try to prevent them from doing that right here, right now, and then turn around and do something very similar on Elodin after that. And then, you know, once we've done those things, those seem to be the two biggest, at least most time-sensitive things for us to do. And, you know, we can then go to Elodin where, or continue to stay on Elodin, where we've done some side quests, but not a ton. We don't yet have an outpost there, so might be worth hanging around there for a little while. And then maybe after that, we progress the more main quest mission component. Alright, so let's... Where was the spot from the dust? Okay. So, did we get this one? Not sure that we did. Because, notably, if there are no cities or what have you, these forward stations are going to be the only places where we can restore our life support. That was not very effective. Ooh. Escape velocity! Perhaps not. Doesn't mean we won't try, though. Here we are.
Automated protocols activated.
Ooh!
Deploying forward station.
Momentum's a little different on here as well.
Mining zones have been added to your nav system,
Pathfinder. Okay, interesting. So it does give us a tiny bit of additional viability points for the basically experience for the increase in the Andromeda Nexus level, but it does not have its own viability meter. So in that way, it's still a little less, it does still help a little bit, but it's not as rewarding as spending time on other planets. And I'm trying to get a better sense of scale now. You know, there's a mining zone over there. What is this? That's code snippets. That's Vetra's loyalty mission. Oh yeah, we should definitely not have that highlighted, otherwise I am eventually going to accidentally go in that direction. Okay, that's another one. Yeah, because I kind of want to use these forward stations as checkpoints of sorts. So, we can probably make it over there quickly enough that we don't have to worry about running out of our life support, but can't say for certain. So, yeah, let's actually mark that. South and slightly west. South, slightly west. Basically along this... Just casually run over that. Basically along this... I thought there was an edge here somewhere. Archeron spine. Sure. That's the Archon bin here. Oh. Oh yeah, you're going to tell me this is a mining location.
This area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
I'm trying to remember which of these is most valuable. Don't think it's magnesium. I think that's common. So, woo, okay, thought that was a never-ending pit for a second there. The TI is titanium, right? A platinum is probably the best, but alas.
Hustle was a good
thing. No, titanium's also people rare.
People from all over,
okay.
Helping out when it mattered. A lot of right ways to help in a crisis. All we needed was coordination. Not too different from how Ryder runs the team.
It works. Might work differently if we were at war.
Lucky we're not, then.
Silicon here, the one that's popping up right now, I believe is uncommon. So that's not that good, comparatively speaking. Maybe we'll take a quick detour, see if we find... now we're out of the zone. Never mind. Oh, it takes a long time to change directions. Even when we change gears. Whoa! Okay, slow down, slow down. Don't fall off the edge. Also, that was a lot. Hold on. Right on the edge of the zone, apparently. And there is a lot of the titanium there. On said edge. Ooh. Right. There we go. Oh, it's like silicon, rather. And no, that's not even uncommon. It's common. Okay, so that's not really great in that case. Whoa! I mean, good air. Although also a whole lot of silicon, which is the thing that I was actually reacting to. Yeah, we just go directly on the geyser thing and get 123 silicon. Okay, now let's get out of here. And it says that the zone is no longer as good. Fair enough. I think we're basically just cutting along the edge of this area here where there is that pit. And well, we can see where the spot is. Going after, basically straight south of here. Or straight ahead, at least. And yeah, level 1 hazard, it's really not that bad.
You went deep with the Asari. Where's the early tech? The motoring museum equivalent.
That was about 30,000 years back. Not much left.
Oh, no Asari Chi-Chi Bang Bang.
Also no Asari Child Catcher.
Ugh, for the best then.
Okay, should be pretty close now. There it is! Hello. That's gonna end up being a hotspot for mining, I'm guessing. Seems like those big geysers or craters. Crater geysers are the best spots for those things.
Mining zones in this region are available, Pathfinder. I've added them to your nav system.
Or not. Okay. So there's an airlock there. That's one of the three locations. One here, that's the last one. Both relatively close to mining zones. And my guess is that, well, yeah, they're to give us parts of a password to unlock the main base. And then the main base might end up being like the cat bases that we've seen a lot of. And on Elladin, that one honestly might be closer still to what we would encounter here, I would imagine, since we aren't fighting cat. Okay. So, it is basically straight, what was that, east? Over here? Wait, what's the other thing that's showing up in the other direction, though? That's Vetra's mission, don't want to do that. I thought there was something that was also pointing over there, but maybe I'm making that up. Zoom. So yeah, we did upgrade that a little while ago. Peregrine Crater.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
Well, that means we overshot a bit, but... I mean, it is the... Platinum is the thing that I really want to try to find here. Even if that is an astronomical quantity of magnesium, that's also obviously the thing we're looking for. They told me there was platinum here. I guess we'll take this. That's the other one as well. Not exactly sure what angle we're supposed to approach from to get in here. This is the spot, and we now have a better sense as to what we should expect when we get in here. That being combat.
Keep your head under fire. I figured Asari only got that calm after a few hundred years.
You can get there in under a century if the right focus is drilled into you.
So, bake 1 hour at 300 degrees or 1 minute at 3000?
Yes, exactly like that.
Non-stop Asari stuff. Okay, so we're gonna get thrown straight into the action here. Okay, this looks like a more defensible position, or at least we have the high ground relative to the spot we got thrown into last time we found ourselves in one of these places. But yeah, that's not gonna help. Oh, we also have a bunch of skill points that we haven't spent yet. We should probably do that, right? Kind of forgot about those. Granted, what we were starting to work on was some stuff that I don't know that we're going to be getting much value out of in the short term. So we're starting to invest more in the biotic stuff, which is admittedly a little gimmicky what I have in mind here, but I would like to at least get a chance to try it out a little bit. So let's see. What do we have? Barrier. Shields restored on biotic kill, 10%. That is actually the thing that I think we will be looking to do in order to enable the gimmick. What's up, Anor? How are you? Doing all right. We are, for the first time, we did just finish a mission that we had been waiting an eternity to do, where we raided the big bad guy's spaceship. The big bad guy trapped us in like a stasis, freezy, force fieldy thing. And so naturally, the only logical way for us to break out of that was to kill ourselves and then revive ourselves, because reasons. Now that we've done that, we have stolen some critical info from said big baddie, but we are also, for the first time, going on to what was previously a full-blown planet that was potentially going to be a place where people might have colonized in this cluster, but has since been broken apart and is basically an asteroid. Yeah, that's a good point. Any time that we die in the future, we should just be asking ourselves why Sam didn't choose to revive us on that occasion. Because it is now canon that we can be revived. You raise a good point there. But yeah, for this upgrade, we could get this shields restored on biotic kill, which technically, in order to enable the gimmick that I'm planning, I think is kind of sort of the thing that we'd want to do, even if under most circumstances this would probably be way more useful, which is probably why I did not yet spend that skill point, because I may have been having some hesitation about that. How much do I want to commit to this funky gimmick that I'm curious to test out? Let's see. Also, what is this? This is the Annihilation, where unarmored, unshielded, normal-sized enemies are lifted into the air. Okay. So this may or may not be one of, / the primary things that I'm looking to do with this gimmick, this build, is do some crazy stuff to enable this. So we're taking it. Can make the case that, you know, better to invest in other more practical things first, and then, you know, as a finishing touch when you're ready to start taking this, actually using this stuff, that's when you spend those points, but, you know, whatever. Then, what's the, let's see, this, hold on, let me refer to my notes. Do I have them here? What were the other components of that crazy one? Yeah, it might require some testing. Of some other skills. I was not 100% sure what the third skill for this build would be. But the other build, which is also biotic, and gimmicky, but not as gimmicky. Well, I mean, goes without saying, but biotic charge, we have to try this out at some point, right? It's usually the Vanguard's class-specific skill, and for that reason, I mean, it's a really cool skill, as is the case for most of the class-specific skills, but in Andromeda, being able to combine those class-specific skills with other class-specific skills, or just using it on a non-Vanguard, is a unique opportunity that I would like to have the chance to capitalize on. Let's see, we can afford this last one. Force damage radius. We have a preference there. Usually, damage is damage. And that's pretty nice, except... Does this come with a radius by default? No, I don't think so. And so at least in Mass Effect 3, usually you do take radius. This is one of the few exceptions to when you do not take just pure damage. Because with charge, since you are putting yourself right next to one, potentially multiple enemies, staggering multiple enemies so that you don't immediately get yourself killed is usually pretty important. And adding the radius is kind of critical to that. So that you, sure, you might take out or at least stagger one enemy, but everyone else standing next to that enemy is going to shoot you dead if you don't have something like this. So I think radius is probably necessary. Then we are out of points. Okay. That's fine, but I am curious to see. Barrier is giving us, yeah, shields and regen delay reduction and shield regeneration based on how many points we've invested in biotics, and we did just invest 16 points in biotics. So let's confirm that. So that's really the only immediately applicable thing is the passive got a little bit stronger, and that's why, as I was saying, you know, it's not going to be the most dramatic of changes in the short term. But for Cora and Liam, I think we might be at the point now where we've established we can fully up, or we can upgrade everything that our squadmates have to rank 5, and then we can only upgrade things to rank 6 if we finish their loyalty missions, and generally speaking, our squadmates, you know, there's only one, the only one we have finished the loyalty mission of is Liam. So tell you what, let's take a close look at him. So we could go all the way here, let's see. So this is his defensive passive. When Liam takes down an enemy, he recovers health and shields. I mean, our teammates do have an amazing knack for kill-stealing for us, but we are generally applying most of the DPS. Shields restored, health restored. It's not a huge number either. After taking down an enemy, Liam gains a temporary damage bonus that stacks up to a max limit. Additionally, Liam's maximum health and shields increase. Damage bonus per kill, 5%. Damage bonus reset duration, 5 or 10 seconds. That's decent shields and health. I mean... For a player character, this would be incredible, because you could just use this to build up some serious momentum and become a killing machine. But, I mean, in either case, not really sure that Liam is going to be getting enough kills to be doing this reliably. So, it says max shields and health. If he is on max shields and health, like he hasn't taken any damage, does that mean that he has gained max shields and max... That he has gained current shields and health? Or is it like the maximum meter increases, but his current shields remain with and health remain what they originally were, and so, you know, he needs to restore his shields or restore his health before he can actually benefit from that extra 25%. I'm guessing not. I'm guessing that you do just not only increase the maximum, but immediately attain that maximum, in which case it is basically the equivalent of getting 5 kills. Oh, well, sort of. For that reason, I think you'd still take this. Okay, military training, his other passive. I think, right? Yeah. Melee attacks deal extra damage over time. I mean, that does add up to something, but I'm not really sure we want to be prioritizing melee damage. Wait. Oh, this is all. Wait, no? This is not melee. This is universally 50% damage to shields and armor? Weapons, skills, everything? That's ridiculous. That is so strong. Power damage to armor. Like, that just doesn't say power damage, doesn't say weapon damage, just says damage. Power damage to armor, power damage to shields. We are really good at taking care of armor. We do have energy drain, so we can take care of shields, but that's not always enough to single-handedly remove shields and... Shields are really bad for Flamer. They significantly reduce Flamer's damage, so I think we still prioritize getting rid of shields here. Then, even if this is boss damage, more often than not, basically we're the boss killing specialist with our Flamer. Power damage, power force, weapon damage, weapon force. I think we have to go the weapon route, because His weapons are just about always available, except for when he's reloading, whereas his powers have long cooldowns. So let's do that. That should make Liam much stronger. And because we finished Liam's loyalty mission, and he's the only squadmate that we finished the loyalty mission of, he's technically, at least potentially, now going to become stronger than any other squadmate. This is overload, 20% damage, recharge speed, damage. What is the recharge speed? It is 20 freaking seconds. That is a very long time. I think for that reason, you take the recharge speed there. Gains one additional target when charged. I have no idea if Liam charges these at all. My guess is he doesn't. Basically, you can use energy, or rather use overload quickly, and it chains only a few times, whereas it chains one additional time if he fully charges it up, and also gets more damage if he fully charges it up. Generally speaking, at least for weapons for squadmates in the previous Mass Effect games, weapons that could charge up, squadmates always just fired them without charging at all. They just quick fire. So I am assuming that it is the same for powers. Can't say that definitively, but I think for that reason we just go for the shield's damage there. And now overload chains to additional target and deals more damage. That's not bad. Overload is now a combat detonator, and targets are stunned for an additional second. 15% all damage, 100% stun duration. I guess it would have otherwise been 1 second, now it's 2 seconds. Tech detonator damage bonus, 50%. So we are priming a lot with flamer. We generally are trying to detonate our flamer with our energy drain, but we don't always have our cooldowns lined up perfectly to do that. So it could make Liam useful in that way. Otherwise, yeah. Yeah. We are priming enemies very, very regularly. So, I mean, it's not going to be that often that he gets the chance to use that detonator, but wait, what? Okay, hold on a second. In what world do you take this? 15% all damage. 15% all damage. Also duration. Also tech detonator damage. There's nothing that this does that this does not do. Wait. Oh, it's... The additional target. Change to the additional target. That's why. Okay, never mind. How many times does it chain then? It does still chain it, I think, even without charging it up. At least once or twice. I want to say it chains twice already. I think that's sufficient to do this. And we just have 3 points, which means we could do that. Sure. Alright, so Liam is now arguably our strongest squadmate. Maybe his combination of skills, not a combination that we are terribly pleased with, but he can reach level 6 with those skills, which is something we cannot save others. Okay, now we're looking at Nova, damage versus armor, or shields. This is the only thing we can upgrade because we've not done Core's loyalty mission. I mean, again, we're kind of the armor damaging specialists. I think we go shields. Okay. And we can't spend those remaining 4 points. Because there are only level 6 abilities left. Okay. Now that we've done that, we have a lot of enemies here. They may not have really noticed us just yet. Well, hold on. I mean, we could try to snipe them. This is kind of a sniping situation. This is also what I mean, though. Like, I'm trying to hit this guy in the head, but it's actually easy. Okay. With the auto aim of the game, it is actually easier to precisely aim this by moving our character rather than moving our reticle. Okay, well, one dead. You know, it's not a terrible opening. It might even be worth trying to stick with this for a little while longer. Oh, hello. Where the heck did that thing come from? All right, now we should switch. Also, they are coming from more angles than I expected them to come from. But we do have the high ground. Therefore, it is impossible for us to lose. I don't know how we are hitting them with the Hurricane from this range. Hurricane does not have that much accuracy. Oh, they... Oh, no. Hey, guys. Turns out they have a mech. It does turn out that they have a mech. I thought I heard a grenade. It might have been Liam's grenade, to be honest. Okay, it should be down pretty soon. Thank you, Cora, for taking all the hits for us. Take it out with the explosion while we're at it. Okay, I'm hoping that means that the difficulty of this encounter comes primarily from said mech. Do we have a sniper that's trying to pick us off here? Oh, well, I mean, it could be this guy. How are they hitting us? You is how. Bob and weave. Bob and weave. I'd like to get to this person while we were searching. There we go. Alright, just pick them off one at a time. And also loot their remains. That human had some Masari stuff for reasons. That is Cora that I'm trying to claim. Oh, that is though. Who's left? Thought there was someone trying to snipe us from over here. Oh, yeah, there's at least one more person. There you are. Oh, you're on a turret. Oh, that is just a turret. It's not manned by anyone, it just is a turret. There are also, I think, still additional enemies. Are there still additional enemies beyond this turret here? There's still someone over there. Somewhere. You. That's the sniper who was messing with us before. This is probably the last person? Yes.
I brought a data pad nearby, Pathfinder.
Okay. We didn't necessarily make a point of looting everybody that we came across, but then again, there's a bunch of minerals for us to get as well, just casually walk around all this uranium, no big deal, really. You don't worry, all the radiation is outside, and we're totally safe from that when we're inside here with the dome. But Lids, the uranium is inside as well. No, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. To get disoriented if I haven't already. Okay. I was not sure if we'd already been to the. No, I was trying to actually put the weapon away so that we don't accidentally melee the uranium. We only mine it. I mean, we're definitely, at least collectively across all of these mineral sources, getting a lot in each of these stations. I mean, of course. Only a very small area on this asteroid that we can explore, so I suppose it needs to all get crammed into one small area. Since we can't go outside the Nomad. So I guess that's the logic. Thank you. obviously the thing we're ultimately looking for is in there, but checking for other minerals and other things to interact with, like you. For some research. Also, oh, come on, yes. Obviously, we want to climb on top of this place. Oh, it's another one of these loadout spots. We can change our equipment if we really wanted to, although I think we are fine. Thank you for asking. Did we get that one? Yes, okay. We did not get this, though. Huzzah. Well, the shield generator did not give us any intel. The roof is not on fire. Ooh, hold on. But this is the floor that has the stuff that we're looking for. Oh, along with this. Indra. Sniper rifle damage, we'll take it. Hey from Kadara. Hey, Kellogg. The gang here has a bet going, and we need to settle this. This Krex guy we keep hearing about, ask him if he's a real scientist and see how he reacts. Like, he's a Krogan, right? Don't they have brains the size of walnuts or something? Oh, we did not know this guy was a Krogan. And we are apparently going to run into him at some point here. Have you actually seen him work? Can he count above 10? Ha! Okay, but seriously. You have to tell me what he's like. I hear he's a nightmare to work with. Come back soon and we can hear all the stories. Holy smokes. We got to try out those Hydras today. I can't believe you left one before they arrived. Caleb, if you could see them in action. With these babies in our lineup, we'll stomp the Collective for sure. So that means these are outcasts? I guess we heard some people, Cora said they're outcasts, right? Outcast and outlaw keeps on getting used interchangeably. One of them is technically the name of the group that opposes the Collective. The other is still a relatively generic term that could be used to describe both the Collective and or the outcasts. What if we could get a few for H047C? I bet they'd kick some serious butt in low G. Maybe you could give Krex an epic punch right in the quad. If you do, take a picture for me. That's true, actually. The gravity should still be low here. There's no reason why the gravity should be different inside the bubble. The bubble is just retaining an atmosphere / protecting the radiation. It's not altering the gravity. You can't really do that with a bubble. Now, there are ways to simulate gravity, but this is not one of them. So we should be flying. In this area, much like, floating more than we usually would, much like we were with the Nomad previously, and I'm disappointed that we are not. Just go for it. We all see the way you stare at Kessia. From the way you two walk, it sounds like you knew each other on Kadara. I'm gonna go out on a limb and guess you came here for her. Just ask her out. You were one of the best smugglers on Kadara. Now you're sitting pretty on a big score from this venture. If that's not most eligible bachelorette material, I don't know what is. Besides, for a Turian, you're not half bad looking. She likes you, trust me. Do us all a favor and close the deal with Kessia. We're sick of you mooning over her. Mooning or moaning? Those are two very different things. Message from Krex. Look, butthole. You can harass me all you want, but it won't make my guys work any faster. You'll get your Helium 3 soil when we're good and finished. You want to ship this back to the base yourself? Fine. Leave my team alone. And we got a little more of the data for the password.
This Krex must be in charge of mining Helium 3. He's the one we need to stop.
The passcode is still incomplete, Pathfinder. I require one more fragment.
Sure, you can't just, brute force your way through at this point. 2/3 of it. You are an AI. don't need every single piece. That might be everything now. Is that a... I see container, though. It has an Avenger! Can't afford to miss one of those. Yeah, we were even over here. We missed it. Initially, at least. We definitely just phased through that. Okay. We may be done. Unless there's something to scan on this side. Maybe done here. Ooh. Already got these dudes. Okay, I think we're good. And the third and final spot is theoretically relatively close by. Now, where's the exit? It does not show. That's...
Dust is packed with valuable resources.
An effect of solar radiation. The radiation is also partly what makes this planet dangerous.
I'm not sure if that checks out scientifically.
I forwarded your deployment ideas to outpost leadership. They'll discuss.
Discuss? We need an implementation plan now.
That's not how civilian outposts work. Still not a war, Cora.
I'm trying to keep it that way.
There's also another question mark here. Okay. Well, I don't know what the question mark is, needless to say. I am curious about this. Maybe don't go down there, though. Unnecessarily. Yeah. But we have discovered the crater, though. That much is for certain. There's our third and final bubble. And this is the proper angle of approach. Last one had a mech in it. A Hydra. Can we... Can we scout it all out at all from... Oh, right, we can't go out of the...
Radiation detected. Please remain in the Nomad.
Can't go out of the Nomad. See some movement there. It actually looks like we can... There we go, from that angle. I see some big beastie dudes. Apart from that... Definitely lots of human-sized enemies, but it's not as if I see a mech. Just checking if we can get any scouting information. Because now in we go.
Nice right. Work.
Also, what is our starting position here? Do have high ground. So that much is nice. Okay, they may notice us here because we aren't that far away from them. How do we want to open? Well, by shooting somebody. Just a normal raider. I think they found us, though. That guy certainly has. I'd also like to no longer be using this weapon. Do you in fact have a sharpshooter? I'd like to keep said sharpshooter. And also the sharpshooter's friend over here. We did not prime that, for what it's worth. Do not know where the next enemy is. means this cloak is gonna go to waste. Oh, there's a turret over there. Is that a turret? I think it is. Somebody below.
Undocumented mineral nearby, Pathfinder.
Yeah, you got the angle on me. I'll give you the... Well done. Well done, Liam. You did successfully send him flying.
Pathfinder.
Was there still a turret over there, though? I thought I might have seen one before we get too complacent here. Platinum that isn't even shy, though. That's the sound of a door opening, not a turret ready, was it? Okay. That's a big container. Don't remember here. I guess Vanquisher is a sniper rifle, which is probably why I didn't pay it much attention before. What's this? Salvage Team 13. The Vagabonds. Log 25. Caitlin Perrow. I've never been so wrong in my life. To think I almost killed Baxter. Dear God. I could have got the whole team killed. All those Ket soldiers and ships we keep running into. They were following the signal we used to track the lockers from the Solarian Ark. Our equipment and tags were like a lighthouse for them. Baxter took Marcus's shotgun and blew a hole in the transceiver just as huge a Ket ship appeared right over our position. I shot Baxter in the leg before I realized he just saved all our lives. Once we got to shelter, Marcus splintered the leg, and I offered Baxter one hell of an apology, plus a contract. I think he said, thank you. I'm stitching his vagabond's patches onto his gear myself. Least I can do. Vagabond's an official title? I mean, again, it's a generic term that one could use to describe these types of people anyway, to a certain extent at least. But, they capitalized it, so I guess that is a third group of... I don't even know what generic terms you used to describe them anymore, because all the generic terms are assigned to a specific subset of them. Outlaws, not to be confused with outcasts. We'll stick to using Baxter's equipment from now on. It'll be harder for the Initiative to track us, but harder for the Ket, too. We'll be okay. We just need to stick together. And this is the key thing we're looking for, though. Checking in, like you asked. Found a decent batch of helium-3 soil here. Think we can mine this for another week at least. Might even be enough for Krex to finish the first one. Feel free to take what we have to the base. It's another fraction of the passcode as well.
Sam, you get that fragment?
I've completed the passcode, Pathfinder, marking the Excel base in your system.
Good. Let's put an end to whatever Krex is doing.
Okay, there's still, I'm sure... Okay, like, here's a little turret. I don't think that's an automated one, though. I think that requires a person next to it, and there are no people left to man it. Thankfully. To the butthole who stole my boots. I get it. We're all bored out here on this place. So you need a little entertainment. You had your fun. Now give them back before I get frostbite on my toes. I'm not angry. Yet. But if I don't see those boots in the next 2 hours, whichever little scumbag did this is getting curb stomped into the excavator. I've been thinking. Never stop and take a look at your life and think, how the hell did I get here? I'm lying here trying to fall asleep and all I can think about is what life would have been like if I hadn't taken a part in that stupid rebellion. I had this picture of how my life was going to go, but Sloan got people so excited, I just kind of went with the flow, without thinking of the consequences. Now I can't even remember what I wanted. Sorry. late night thinking and all that. Nothing I can do about it now. I guess you always just give good advice, and you were the first person I thought to contact. Don't expect you to say anything to make me feel better. I just needed to get it out. Sleep well. We'll talk soon. I'm fine. I know you're worried, but I'm okay. I promise. Elodin is fine. Sure, it's about 1,000 degrees, water is sold at a premium, and everyone is trying to kill me. But other than that, I'm great. That was supposed to make you laugh. Now I can just picture you worrying about me all over again, but really, I'll be okay. I got in good with one of the gang leaders here, Big Terran, and he's treating me alright. And the salvager who flies here from Kadara said she can bring me supplies if I have the credits. But I'm better off than you, scooping dust from a busted planet. Hang in there, okay? Life right now might be a little rough, but we're just backstage. Our time in the spotlight is coming. Oh, what the? Okay. Sure. Radiation sensor, pressure sensor, magnetic core, stable. Readings normal. This device creates an artificial magnetic field as a measure of protection against solar radiation. And probably could have scanned those in any of the other bases, but I didn't realize they were scannable. Oh, another loadout spot. Don't really need, but sure. That is an intel note. So that's some research. We've not made a concerted effort yet to mine the very outgoing platinums. Not a shred of timidness in these platinums. Not one bit. Yeah, I don't know how significant those logs are and what have you. Like, obviously the big one that told us about the main person running this whole operation, that one, sure. But the other ones we get from the non-directly quest-related dialogues that we read, I think, those are purely just flavor text, if you will, of sorts. So that is the way out, though I'm still not sure that we've gotten everything here yet. Definitely made a point of mining those. There was a rock here I thought that we'd never seen before that Sam was telling us about. Is that still the case? Yes. We should do that. Can we scan the actual wall itself? I didn't try. No, we can't. Okay. Just checking. Just telling me we're getting close to the rock. Is it this rock? It is not this rock. It's something very close to that rock, though. Tell me it's not that rock. Is it this rock? It's not that rock. That rock is old news. Here. Ah, it's this rock. What's element zero? I can't mine it though? Point geophysics VI for scan performances. 35% improvement over projections. The VI is performing satisfactorily, transmitting data to Chief Lucan. Okay. If you say so. Gotten these? Okay, I think may now be at the point where we've gotten just about everything. So I think we probably head out now. Okay. That is... assuming... yeah, okay, right here. That's where we know where to leave, and we do. Okay.
Sam, I need info on the Exile base. What do you have for me?
The base is comprised of two mining domes. The second can only be accessed with a passcode. I also detect multiple frequencies originating from the area. They have communication with Kadara.
Okay, not really sure what the significance of that is. We did hear them mention Kadara on several prior occasions. Where are they, though? Oh, on the exact opposite side. Naturally. Okay, we do have this mining zone here and here that we may want to hit along the way. Otherwise, I guess we're just going forward station to forward station on our way over. Guess we didn't get that one. And we could relatively quickly and easily if we were to fast travel back there, but now is not the time for that, I don't think. There's also potentially some things over here, as there is a pathway that leads into this dark unknown area that we have not explored.
Are we good, Cora?
If I can get civilian operation through my head, yes.
We need to go west before we go north, right? Because there appears to be a big divide over here. Yeah, okay.
Just remember that I came by a lot of my skills the hard way.
Look, it's not easy being a Asari commando, okay?
Now I'm imagining the picture you'd have on the front.
It's so difficult, in fact, to be an Asari commando. It's almost impossible to be one.
Pathfinder, this area can be
when you're not an Asari. You almost, but not quite.
Your mining interface.
Okay, we did mine there already. Yeah, well, not the most exciting of mining areas. Thought we'd take a quick moment to see if there's anything we could nab along the way, but you know, maybe it's not worth it after all. Alright, so that, let's just double check. That was the place we've already been to. We do have a forward station here where we can reset our life support. Somewhere. In this general, oh, there it is. Alright. Now we can basically go straight north. Okay, we're gonna hit escape velocity right here, right now. Hold on. Oh, wait. Oh, I needed that run up. I needed that run up. Also, that is probably the place for Vetra's loyalty mission. 1 second. We are going to hit escape velocity. Wait for it. Wait for it. Wait for it. Still not as fast as I wanted it to be.
No more
not quite.
Ops, Liam. That mess with Kallet can't happen again.
We had to deal with him eventually.
I just prefer more controlled circumstances.
I'll try. But I was in crisis response, not controlled circumstances response.
Okay, oh, yep. It does require that we go further west after all. Not ready to go north, actually. Oh, apparently we've already tried mining this spot and it's not great anymore. Okay, no worries. Further west. That's dramatic.
It's so quiet here. Like the ghost of a planet.
It's nothing
it
like the stills
is.
I saw. Strange to think that was hundreds of years ago.
Whoa, that was weird. Do we have to go on this... this bridge? We may. See, I don't want to go here. But it does seem like that's possibly one of the only ways across to this western half. Okay, let's just take it nice and slow. Whoa, and slow.
That's unsettling.
Hey, don't worry about it.
Suvi Anwar is correct. Cosmic radiation is unusually high on this planet, likely an effect of the Scourge.
Let's say I just walked out into it. What would happen?
Cosmic rays would penetrate the molecules of your DNA. Terminal cancer is highly likely.
Suddenly, I'm thankful for the Nomad.
Yeah, also, there'd probably be significant... Well, definitely the cancer part. But quite likely, depending on just how strong it is, some significant short-term effects as well. Namely, death. Oh, I did not know that there was a gap. I did not know that there was a gap there. Okay. Well, now we know. Now we know. I mean, that might have actually been possible to make that if I had known in advance and jumped and boosted and what have you. Now I'm actually very tempted to try that. Now I really want to try that. We did go past this forward station, which... I mean, maybe... maybe it's worth getting... Or we could back up, get some nice speed like we had before, and deliberately boost and jump across. I mean, it just so happened, the place that we went across, by the looks of things... is the place where the gap is most narrow. So I guess if there is a place to do it, this would be it. I mean, you have to wonder. We weren't that far off, and I did not boost, I did not jump. So,
Liam, I'm getting a lot of anomaly reports from one prospector.
Meanwhile, Cora really and Liam are completely unfazed.
All in Lloyd. Travels solo and reads too many spy comics. Could probably change his breather more often. Just forward it to me. I'll translate for Colonial Affairs.
Maybe loop in a psychiatrist. Freud would love this guy.
Right. Get him a tincture of lithium while we're at it.
Now I am going back for this. Yes, I see the gap to the left.
Automated protocols activated.
Oh, look at that.
Forward station.
Beautiful stop. Just ignore the fact that I was trying to turn in the opposite direction. You don't need to know that. This is totally what I planned to do.
Mining zones have been added to your nav system, Pathfinder. Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources.
Also, the...
extract minerals via your mining interface.
Yes, this may not have viability on this asteroid. Yes, it may, however, still give us overall Andromeda viability points, but two is not exactly a huge difference maker. Oh, it gave us this one all the way over here, which is on the very edge of the planet. Yeah, no thanks. I think I'm going to pass on that one. Now we basically just backtrack to exactly where we were, and this time we make the jump. We succeed. Oh, never mind. There's apparently a mining zone right on top of us. There's a mining zone right on top of us. I guess we'll take it. I mean, it's magnesium, which is not very good, but we'll take it. Oh, we've not been... we've been in off-road mode this whole time. We haven't even been in speed mode. Oh, just imagine. Just imagine the potential. Hold on, we need to plot our course here. We're going for the forward station, obviously. I mean, the fact that there is a path that directs us toward the forward station probably means there's going to be a bridge here, much like we saw before, but we're not going to use that bridge.
You're better than your listed training. You had a mentor.
I had a team who didn't want me to die. Still do, right?
There's the bridge. We are going to ignore it. We're going to try. We're going to try.
Ryder!
It's too wide over there. But we might have gotten the forward station. We got the forward station! It's okay, we got the forward station! Okay, it's definitely possible to make the jump. If you go, look, see, we got it. Your nav system, Pathfinder. We got the forward station. It was fine. It all worked. But it is definitely possible to make this. If you go, yeah, right here, it's elevated a little bit more. The gap is more narrow. We're now using the speed mode rather than the all-wheel drive mode. This time we are going to deliberately use our boost and our jump, and we're going to make it happen. We are going to make it happen.
Ryder, look out!
It's possible! Anything is possible. Anything is possible? Don't ever say that it can't be done.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
Okay. And again, the titanium and the platinum are the best. I think we've established that silicon is actually common. Just bad, but it is here in somewhat significant quantities. Hold on. There's always something in the crater. There's always something. No, there's not anything of particular note in that crater. Okay, well.
Tighten up, Costa. I'm not getting flanked because you're distracted.
Do you prefer Batarian Flood, Roman Column, or Elcor Core?
Just pick one and stick to it.
Out of the zone. I'm in the zone. Thank you very much. Obviously, the best mining location is going to be... I'm fine, but obviously the best mining location is going to be right here. That goes without saying. Or on the bridge. It's a really small mining location. It, despite being rich, does not seem to have anything other than the stuff that we just mined. Oh, that made me a little nervous for a second there. don't know why it would, but, you know. Surely we are fine. Surely we're fine. Not like we've had any sort of traumatic experiences in the past. Plunging into the depths of the craters that line this asteroid. Also, we are now trapped for all of eternity. Zoom. There, we are approaching the place we were looking to go. Okay. Okay.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources.
Alright.
Extract minerals via your mining interface.
Can it give us anything better than silicon? Or is that it? Also, we may need speed to get up this. Really? Wow. Okay then. I mean, obviously the best resources are going to be on the mountaintop, which is why I'm insisting on doing this. But maybe I will insist no longer. Maybe I will insist no longer. Yes, I tried to go on the angle where it was not as steep, and then
trigger discipline cost.
Nomad insisted on not doing that.
Harper.
That must be the base the Exiles mentioned.
Hold on. Yeah, it looks pretty good. And sure, we'll check for a little more over here while we're at it. If we don't fall to our doom over here. Despite this not seeming to be a very steep hill here, it is insurmountable. Also, why is there a... Oh, it's just because we're over there. Yeah, okay. It's like... Not sure why you're telling us to scan that also. I didn't really mean to do that, but okay. Apparently we did that. Okay, well, slow down. Slow down. Well, I mean, there's the entrance. Yes, it's two bubbles, which we heard about previously. So, presumably that just means it's like we had before. It's just two separate instances of the same type of encounter. And they have ranged a little bit in difficulty. Depends a lot on the cover that we have, and do they have a big mech? And my guess is... this is going to be a difficult one, because this is the last one, and they are already coming up to get us. It does seem as though they do already know that we're here.
Right between the eyes.
I guess so. I guess so then.
Like outlaws.
Yes, these pariahs seem like they are of a particularly strong variety. Despite being of human shape, well, despite being human and not seeming to be of particular significance, they are, I think, one of the stronger enemies like you. Important. What is your deal? Yeah, you're an anarchist. You have all the armor. You're dead now. That's a chunk of experience, suggesting that technically that was one group of enemies, and this is another. Oh, there's a turret here. Okay. Noted. So, exactly how much range that turret has? There it is. I guess there are other enemies here as well.
Second dome, Pathfinder.
Set it up, knock them down.
Yeah, that's not great. That's not great. That's not great. Not do that, preferably. I didn't appreciate the way that you did that before. I demand a formal written apology. You just try to jetpack away from us. Well, you didn't tell us how much experience we got, but apparently it was enough to level. So we know that much. Okay. And tier 6 research projects unlocked. I thought we already had some of those unlocked, but okay. We have some skill points to spend though. So we're looking at charge, what we were doing most recently. Improves weapon and melee damage for 3 seconds after charging, or enhances all powers for 5 seconds after charging. That, I think, is what we're looking for here. I think that's what we're looking for. And we can afford this, so that's cool. Okay, we do have one additional point left, but maybe we'll just hold on to that 1 point. Time being, and that gives us Sentinel rank 4. Now wait, Sentinel? Is that the one that we want? I think that is the one that we technically prefer, isn't it? Engineer, we have rank 4. So all combo damage, 35%, that is good. That's just about the only positive thing that we're getting out of this. Whereas if we go the Sentinel route, now it's the same rank. It's rank 4 as well. It's 5% less combo damage. However, that 25% tech recharge speed And power shield cost reduction is not relevant at the moment, but it may become relevant in the future. It's mostly that losing 5% damage to gain 25% recharge speed, which I think is a pretty solid trade. Damage is great, of course, don't get me wrong. But 25% recharge speed is not bad either. Okay, so now that we've taken out the enemies in this section, let's scavenge around a little bit more. So I think we did walk past some things. I kind of thought this was going to be something. Apparently it isn't. Oh, our squad mates as well. Cora, you have six... All right, Cora can't do anything until we do her loyalty mission, but Liam does not have enough skill points anyway. Never mind. Is this a building? What is this thing? That's one of the research notes. I will not be denied. Also, we will probably get stuck here anyway. Okay, you know, maybe there isn't anything over there. Maybe there just isn't anything over there. Oh, that's the kind of thing I'm looking for. Significantly less rocks of the mining variety in this location. Nothing to loot on this side. Okay. That may mean we're going full speed ahead, unless there's something else hiding up here. That does not appear to be the case. Alright, so that was dome area number one. Now we should have the password to access dome area numero dos. Okay. There we'll... presumably still be enemies here. And this may be a more difficult encounter. Titanium, now these are the rocks we like to see. And this looks a lot more like the actual bases, the official Ket base, outlaw bases that we've seen in the past. So that's kind of what I expect to see here now. Are they gonna have... oh, well, okay, hello. Oh, right, I don't have cloak anymore. Wait, no, I do have cloak. I was like, oh, we switched. We don't have cloak anymore because we're no longer an engineer. No, that's not what gave us the cloak before. Also, they have a broken cloak. That looks like a particularly big dude. Well, that's Krex. That's the leader. Yes, we do, in fact, have a sharpshooter. I did see someone over here. That's because they're right next to me. Ow. Ow. Okay, granted, we don't recharge our shields when we cloak. So when we can, when we're shieldless, it is going to take a second there to do stuff like this. Hello. Hello, friend. So... the other thing, it doesn't really talk about much, but that we did get when we were back doing our engineering stuff, was that we had the little combat drone that could never really tell how significant that was. But we've lost that, and we now have tech armor, I believe. Oh. Which gives us additional damage reduction, I assume? That sounds like a grenade that may or may not be Liam's. I don't really know. Oh. Well, that enemy may have been involved. I can't really hit you right now. But I can do that.
That takes care of Crux and his people. But what were they up to?
I detect an audio log nearby, Pathfinder. It may give you the information you need.
Hey, also, I know we just leveled, but that was a lot of experience from that. Did Crux himself drop anything? Seemingly not. Can we scan the stuff over here? Yes, we can. Exile shuttle that you were hiding. Due to recent repairs on the vehicle, it is likely Krex was planning a trip to Katara in the near future. Does have minor hull damage. Destination was Katara. Oh. Shy Titanium? No, surely not. I assure you, that is not a thing. I mean, it won't even let me jump onto this. Wow. Invisible wall at the top. I was about to ask if we could commandeer this thing. And if not, I was gonna do that. Oh, wow. Ooh, okay. Ah, yes. We technically could craft level 6 items before, but we were not able to. Seemingly, we're not able to drop level 6 items. We were still dropping level 5 when we were on level 40. Now we're on level 41. Apparently, we can drop level 6 items. So this is the first time we've seen level 6 Rieger and Sandstorm. So, okay. That's certainly not bad in that case. Oh. In that case, Scalar. What? Present on scaling attachments, but not on the hull of the machine. Though its intended purpose is the removal of loose debris underground, this scalar has been used to mine the surface of H047C. Either its operator is unaware of its function, or the exiles have limited resources for proper mining. That's where we came in. Okay. Don't mind if we do. Okay, now we may have. What's that? May have looted just about everything there is to loot outside of the interior here. But I'm stuck. There's something here. Of significance. Weak point damage, no thanks. I mean, if you're a sniper, and I can see how that could be useful, but it's not really what we're focusing on. What is it that you're beeping and booping at me about? It's actually up on the second floor. Starting to get that feeling. Oh, well, there's this. Regarding your question, thanks for coming to me first with this. It'll be tough since H047C is practically an asteroid field, but if anyone can pilot a ship through that mess, it's my crew. I'll get you whatever you need. I'll have to double my rates because of the risk involved. I'm sure you understand. But I promise you, in 2 weeks, you'll be walking around with a shiny new toy. Hope you use it well. This might have been the shipments of the ship that we just saw. Hey, kiddo. I know you'll yell at me for messaging you. Yeah, maybe I'll get in trouble. I don't care. Mortar can kiss my butt. You really should see the colony, Krex. We've done all right for ourselves. Good protection, great deal with the N'Gara in charge, even scientists working on agriculture. You'd like it here. Warren asks about you sometimes. Says if you want to come back, there's a place in his lab for you. It has to be better than whatever you're doing over there. Just think about it, okay? Barak, don't think we've heard that name before. We need you to do something. We need to do something. Look, I don't like her any more than you do. But who else do we follow? Sloane? Who takes more than her share of the score? Some charlatan joker we've never seen? I'll take my chances with an overambitious child. Just lay low and do what she says. We'll find a way to stack the cards in our favor. And we'll take over before it's too late. And we have the Nexus swooping down to tear us to pieces. Oh, that might have been what it was beeping at us about before. Also, this is the spot of the key item. So let's nab it.
I don't want excuses, Krex. The dust on the surface isn't enough. If I want to take
the initiative, I think we've seen this name before.
We'll need a hell of a lot more helium-3. I know that remnant tiller in the conservatory will work. Get it running. Elora out.
It's that Asari from Kadara. She wanted to attack the colonies. But it sounds like they couldn't activate some sort of remnant tiller. Sam?
An active remnant tiller would expose more soil to radiation, increasing helium-3 production exponentially. If my calculations are correct, this planet could fuel Nexus ships for an estimated 368 years.
Oh. Well, that would be kinda nice.
Our Milky Way supply will run out eventually. Now we won't have to worry. We need to get that tiller up and running.
I've marked the Remnant Conservatory on your display.
If Elora had mined enough helium-3 to bomb the colonies...
I advise against hypotheticals, Pathfinder. I've alerted the Nexus to the situation. Patrols will be stationed around this planet to ensure the helium-3 remains in your control.
Still, when I see Elora again, we're having a chat.
Okay, I remember we spoke to her. I don't remember... Mostly I just remember her name. I don't really remember much beyond that. Oh, that's the... Oh, and you're letting me climb on the ship now. Wasn't this the one that it wasn't letting me climb onto before? Oh. Oh. See... You see, the thing is... Not sure we were supposed to do this. Only one way to find out. We have found the invisible wall. And by that I mean the invisible platform. Because we are a good... What? 10 feet above the ship? Down we go on the invisible ladder. Okay. Alright. Well then. I think we're now done here, and we have secured the helium-3 on this location, which we will use for fueling the ships in and around the Nexus initiative, rather than allowing bandits to use it to create bombs. Oh, we have to walk back through the other spot as well. That's a little more fun. All right. Okay. So, that does mean that, oh, that's still, yeah, that's just the place where we just were. Okay, nothing new there. So yeah, that does mean that we've now done what is probably, oh no, there is still the, yeah, they alluded to something else here. I wasn't sure. Wasn't super clear what we had and had not still done this. The Outlaws discovered a remnant device in the remnant conservatory here. They believed would unlock vast quantities of helium-3 to exploit. Obtain that supply for the initiative. Okay, so maybe we have not yet secured that helium-3. That still remains in the hands of these bandits. So I'm not really sure. In that case, it sounds like we are not safe from them potentially making a bomb just yet. We need to go here. So it looks like there's still one more step that we need to take here. Also, it does look like there's just a big loop. Basically, there's the big chasm in the middle. There are bridges that cross at key points. So that's what seemingly this does. And then, I don't know, there's probably a mining location that you only get once you go to this forward station, which is right next to this one. But again, maybe we'll poke our head over there when we're about to head out. So, speaking of forward stations, in fact, I guess this one might be worth using.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
Alright, so away we go. Yeah, in this general direction. Mm-hmm. Whoa! I think we found it. Was there another mining location around here as well? Beyond it, yeah. Not that that's a huge deal, but okay, which side has the entrance? Far side. So, I guess in some ways you could see this as the final encounter. Technically, this is a different quest, but you could sort of see this as the final encounter of the previous mission. This could be a difficult one. Maybe you can go in here even before you do the other stuff if you happen to come into this remote corner of the planet. I'm not sure. It is still so weird to me the way you just quite literally drive Nomad straight in. This is a terrible spot to be. We are at a choke point. Unless we are not immediately getting swarmed by enemies, unlike all the other locations like this. All right, fair enough. As we were saying, it is technically a different quest. Shipping container. I mean, I suppose that's generic enough. Is there anything in the container, though? There's a container in the container! Containerception. Is there a container in the container in the container? No, but there's another Rieger. This is making me feel like, I mean, this looks a lot like a vault. Looks like it's gonna take us into an entirely different area. So if anything is like a full-fledged base, like we've had on other planets, the Kent bases, the Outlaw bases, this may actually be it in terms of quantity of enemies. The previous spot where we had the double bubblegum, got close to that, I suppose, but still the dynamic was a little bit different. This really looks like a vault. Like, I mean, really, really looks like a vault. And we cannot save. Okay. because of his fault. I mean, I know they said it was remnant tech, but I was not under the impression that this was a full-fledged vault that has just conveniently been renamed to something else. So that means this is probably a pretty significant endeavor. Not the type of endeavor that I was anticipating. I mean, I wasn't anticipating something big, but just more outlaw-y and less remnant-y, I suppose.
Sam, how do we get the tiller working?
I detect a console deeper inside.
Okay.
We could use it on our side.
I don't like your laser beams, but I'd appreciate it if you would stop laser beaming me. So, part of me is hoping that because this is not a vault by name, this is not necessarily going to be quite as extensive of a dungeon, if you will, as the vaults would normally be. Because, well, you know, we've had some mixed experiences with those. Alright, let's activate the console. I mean, obviously, in the past, they've always been very important.
So much better when they're on our side.
Oh.
Its protocols are limited, but it will perform simple tasks for you via your scanner.
By our scanner, you say? How exactly does that work? Oh. Okay. I'm going to respond to remnant input, specifically observer type. Oh, hey, it's just being pokey. Or we were standing in the way. Can we scan him, though? No. Alright, well, there are more enemies.
Here they come! We can lay low or take them on.
Okay. What can we lay low or take on? Like, those remnant look pretty unavoidable to me. And we do have a tactical cloak. So if we're talking about stealth, we do have a pretty convenient way to do that. And that looks like other spots we've seen in the past from the most recent vaults where, yes, our shields slowly get depleted when we step in those, but those were devices that we could activate in that case, which is what I was assuming would happen, but we could not interact with those. So I'm not really sure what the significance is in that case. Sometimes, even if there isn't anything that looks officially scannable, scanning in the remnant areas does still pay some dividends. So, yeah, what is the significance here? Just double check. I cannot interact with these. Oh, that one did not deplete shields. But also, I don't see the remnant incoming. So I think Liam may have just lied to us. Okay, I'll be honest. I'm not entirely clear on what we are supposed to be doing right now. And by that I mean, I have no idea what we are supposed to be doing right now. Explore the Remnant Conservatory. Okay. Oh, okay, we can proceed through this way. Gotcha. And I feel like there's probably some significance to the place we were just in, but didn't find anything. You know there's gonna be I mean, we're Like, are we activating something that, much like the vault, is going to require that we come rushing out here at the end? It seems at this point like it is basically a vault in all but name. Do we have a map? We do have a map. Came in this way? I don't know. I mean, generally, I would say it is good to be thorough when you are in these types of locations. Because they're usually pretty few and far between. That's where we just came from, right? Is it? Yeah, we have a remnant device here of some variety.
I don't think we're done here.
Okay, an astute observation. But we cannot interact with this ourselves. Looks like we need to get one of those remnant dudes activated to assist us. And how do we make that happen? Some other console somewhere? Oh, that's where we just were. Maybe we go around the other side? Or maybe in those things? You know, that it does look significant. That might not be the exact spot that we were in before, despite it looking somewhat similar. Is it? Oh, I'm so disoriented. It definitely is. It definitely is. South. East, then south, or maybe west, then south, which we've not tried at all. Maybe we try that real quick. Yeah, this one's safe. Oh. Hello. That's a pretty big one. That nullifier there. I don't like the fact that it is taking notice of us.
Up high, down high.
Ow.
Another observer comes.
Okay. Now that we've dealt with those guys, I did see the console, yes. That's the spot where it came from. That's the console. Oh, that's also a console.
Looks like we need an observer for this.
Okay, so it seems like there's just one observer that you get first, and it may be this one. We have to. It should just be friendly, right? It's a friendly one. Don't worry about it. He's nice. This one's nice. Just gonna zap this device, and then we'll be good to go, right? Just takes a little bit of time. Or do we need to scan it in order to make that happen? We need to give it the go-ahead by scanning. Despite the fact that we'd scanned it beforehand. No, not there. Did our friend run off to the other spot? Oh!
Looks like there's a trick to this interface. Let's figure it out.
Okay, also Liam was saying something that suggested that we were going to have enemies to face? We do have enemies around here? Somewhere? Okay. They're on the other side of this wall, I think. I think we might just experiment. Oh, well, this one we can't interact. Oh, alright. Don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I do. That's the one that it already messed with. So yeah, let's just see what happens here.
They must have left a hint behind somewhere.
Okay. I mean, there's the light that is pointing. What? The other consoles. There's a light pointing in a certain direction. This one has the spinny wheel thing as well. It has the windmill on top. Whatever that means. I don't know what that means. Other than that we may be looking for that symbol elsewhere. Like, on the other side where we were before? I don't know. Maybe that means we go over here now? To this one? Alright, it does have the...
I don't think we're done here.
The windmill thing. Turbine.
I don't think we're done here.
This obviously is not open, though. See, I didn't sign up for this. But also, I just don't see where all the various things we can mess around with are, or at least the ones that we can use. It's not even clear to me what our options are. Is that the one that we got? And I'm not sure this is... Okay, hold on. Well, it made baddies show up, apparently. Which usually means that we did it the wrong way. Usually that is the signal for, hey, you messed up. Oh, I don't know if we saw this one. Ah, okay, so this is one, I see. This is one of the Orby things, so this goes first. And the one that we did see has two of the Orby things, so that goes second. See? One and two. See, I didn't even know the other one existed. Oh, it might have caused the remnant to pop up. Okay, that didn't really do anything when we did that, but... Now, is there another one hiding somewhere that is three? I mean, both of those are open now. So that may now have opened things up elsewhere, like here, that I don't think was... No, that was open. Ah, but now this one... Now we see that this device was here. I mean, I don't see the number of objects, but we're gonna do it because it's in the area and it is connected to the ones that appear to already be activated. Yeah, Maybe we just don't step into the thing there? No, don't you create more. Oh, nope, they're not all dead. Okay, we are now, I think, making progress. Okay, so you need to get another one of them. And we'll do the same thing here. It'll unlock those doors. Okay. I think we are starting to get how it all pieces together here. Oh. Well, I didn't expect that. Take this while we're at it. I was assuming that Observer would pop up somewhere nearby. Although, obviously, there is that bridge, which we will want to use. I just was not sure if we would want to go that far when it seems we need something I would have thought nearby for that. I don't know. I guess we'll cross the bridge. It certainly looks significant. That doesn't look good, though. You know, the big purpley flames of death? I mean, it is pointing us in that direction. Yeah, that is weird. There's definitely stuff over there that, I mean, we appear to just be running away from at this point. Ow. Ow. We are in a very bad spot. We're in a very bad spot. Hello, sir. I would like to have, damaged your armor a little more before doing that. Our powers combined. With our powers combined, we are unstoppable. I assume it was something for the combos? Probably stuff for...
Coordinated strike now!
Okay, probably something for priming slash detonating combos with actual squad mates. We've done a bazillion combos with just us. Ooh, nice. But we recently made some upgrades that made it more possible for us to combine with squad mates with combos, which is something that we did not make much of a point of doing previously because we were thinking if there are long cooldowns, it would not be very effective. So we could... Oh? Hold on. More enemies. Ow. Oh. Oh, it's a big one. That there is a big one. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy, old pal. Now I will admit, after crisscrossing a bit all over the place, yeah, I started to get confused, but this was the side that we were unable to unlock previously. Okay. One that we needed, still needed, an observer for. So we are locked out from this angle unless and until we deactivate you. Though that does raise some questions as to what different combinations of these things would do. She's kind of obnoxious, given how much it requires that we run around, but... perhaps there are things that we can do now that we couldn't do before. We did also level. Oops. Wrong menu. My bad. So for charge, last one we can either see. Fully restore shields and reduces incoming damage for 5 seconds. A little bit of extra damage as well. Or much better recharge speed. What is the recharge speed? 8 seconds. Better than 8 seconds. We have a bunch of armor we can get for reducing tech. Or improving tech recharge speeds. I don't remember if we've seen that for biotic stuff. I mean, thus far we haven't really paid much attention to it because we haven't really used much in the way of biotics, so that may be why. It may still exist. 75% is a ton. Though... I mean, that is crazy frequency. And that's like more than cutting this in half. So less than 4 seconds in between all those charges. Versus... yeah. And that's pretty tough to turn down, getting the full shield restoration. And one of the reasons why I was eyeing before the full upgrade on barrier for the shield restoration, I think was because... wait, no, it's this one. Is because I wasn't sure if we were going to take the full restoration on charge. So this kind of makes up for that. By taking this, you may be able to take the faster recharge on charge. So... those two are... there's definitely a lot of interrelatedness there. Though I might wait a little bit in between streams and do some number crunching to see just what that starts getting us to in actuality for recharge time. It says 6 seconds here. That's before we get the additional cooldown. And I think we've noticed in the past that this does not really reflect all of the bonuses that we have in an ability. Forget what it does not include when it calculates those numbers. But the other thing that we are planning on doing eventually for biotics, and you could probably imagine this based on what direction we've been going in thus far, is that we're recreating some Vanguard stuff from Mass Effect 3. Charge and Nova, of course, the key Vanguard combo in Mass Effect 3. So, sure, we'll invest some points in this since that is a direction we intend to go quite soon. So, basically, you charge in, then you Nova. Charge in, get right next to the enemies, have an AoE on it because we added the radius to that, and then you slam around them with the Nova, also with the radius, also staggering them, knocking them back and what have you, keeping yourself a little bit safer when you're right next to a bunch of people. And, well, that's all we can do for the time being there. Double check. Now we're on to 11% shields and regeneration delay reduction and all that stuff. Okay. Means now we've unlocked the next level of Adept, but I don't think we're interested in doing that. Core, we know we can't do anything else on Liam. We may be able to... yes, we can go Frag Grenade now, or if we'd like to, we could wait until we could afford an upgrade to Havoc Strike. Power, or Damage Force. More weapon damage, melee damage after Havoc Strike. More power damage. I mean, we're definitely going to want it this one, I think, because... you know, what are the chances that Liam's going to be able to manage his cooldown so that he's using a different power immediately after Havoc Strike? Probably pretty low. So maybe we wait for that. Otherwise, Frag Grenade is damage or damage radius. What is the radius? 5 meters. And usually you go for damage, right? Yeah. Especially because, again, when it's a CPU controlling it, we don't know how much of a point he's going to make of throwing a grenade where there are multiple enemies clustered close together, so don't really know how much he's going to be able to take advantage of this, whereas damage is damage. At least you're getting the main target there. So, yeah, Sure. See, he has this is on a cooldown, yeah, whereas we would use power cells for, right? I guess we could do this. Well, no, actually, let's save, because I would like to kind of keep one power that's a little bit lower so we can at least make use of some points when we don't have a huge amount stockpiled. Okay, now, granted, I've lost all recollection of where we are. Activate both of these, right? One. This is the two. So we came over here to see if there's anything new to do. I don't really think there is. Unless we're doing this again. To get you out here. But not sure that you do have anything to do. Alright. Well, we checked. Oh, also, wait, how do we... Can we still go through this way? So I thought we established that we couldn't. Unless we change one of our other consoles. Look. I don't know, man. Console in question, I think, was the one right there. And get us back through. This here. So I think we have to deactivate this. It closes that door, it opens this one up. That's not open. That's also not open. I am displeased. Can we just go through doors now? I think I'm probably just gonna ignore the other stuff at this point. To be brutally honest, I'm usually quite patient when it comes to trying to get any and everything, but I think I have lost my patience for running around trying to activate and deactivate those things to find the precise combination that we need to access absolutely everything. Five iron? I read that correctly? That's insane. That's nothing. That's a common resource. Also, what are you telling me to scan? There's nothing over here? Ultra rare. Weapons, when clips empty, restore shields, or on chest plates, enemies killed, restore shields. That sounds pretty freaking good. Restoring 25% shields when we destroy an enemy, that is incredible. Turns our offense directly into defense. Okay, again. I am getting very disoriented from all this, but we are technically headed in the right direction, theoretically. Well, now, checking to see if there's other good stuff over here. Did we use this to get in here? Is this how we got in here? Yeah, that's a good one. Which means this is probably the way through. What do you need me to scan? This? That? I'll be honest, buddy, I don't know where you're trying to tell me to go. This one? I can't tell if you're following me because this is the right direction, or if you're following me just because you always follow me. Take it, it's the ladder. In theory, yes, we're headed in the right direction. Oh, this is the place where... Uh-oh. That doesn't look good. You know, the purple death flames, those don't look good. The enemy with a huge skull on top of it, that doesn't look particularly good. He's creating more of those guys as well. Yeah, we're doing almost no damage to this dude. I think we fought one of these guys before. And it did not go particularly well at the beginning. In part because our squad mates kept on trying to walk right next to him, and I think that is very clearly not what you are supposed to do to this guy. Our problem is our best damage comes against armor. You have a humongous amount of shields, so you don't want to be anywhere near them when they do that, otherwise you're gonna die. Ow. Ow. Oh yeah, everyone else is dead, by the way. Where is our squad mate that I thought went down over here? That's just great. That's just great, is what that is. Where are... Okay, this also drains our shields when we go in those things. Where are they? Okay, I see Liam now. I also accidentally deactivated the cloak. In case it wasn't obvious, this is a very difficult encounter. And I would like to revive Liam right now, or Cora rather. A was about to say, admittedly, I was not checking where the big enemies were. Oh my god. This is a situation where, this is also the wrong idea. This is a situation where I would, we're about to, okay, well, I pressed the wrong button. in case that wasn't obvious. That was supposed to be the button to activate our shields. That's the situation where in multiplayer, I would love to pull out a missile launcher, blow that thing up and go, have a nice day. I do not, I do not want to take you on right now. Our squad mates are not smart enough to take on this enemy.
Watch out, remnants.
Squad mates are not strong enough to take this guy on, or not smart enough to take this guy on, because they just run straight up into him and get killed almost immediately by the explosiveness. Okay, I'm not sure if this is gonna get the attention of the other dudes. But I mean, you saw how little damage we dealt to it. Okay, yes, we've gotten its attention. Can we use the purple flames of death to deal more damage to it? That is now what I'm wondering. Because if so, then that may be our best friend. Squad mates has either already died or that was a grenade. I honestly don't know. Just trying to wait long enough to kite this guy over. Excuse me? Kite this guy over into. Okay, now we're gonna get hit by this. Over into one of these things. Also, we can get health back by doing this. Four is down. What happens? I need to now know what happens. What? Oh my god. This is like not anywhere near. Okay, did it? It just didn't do the thing that I just told it to do. First of all, there's that. Should have restored our shields and it just didn't. So there's that. I forgot what else I was talking about, but yeah. Exponentially more difficult than any other encounter we've had thus far. Not even close. We have fought one of these guys before. When we did, the way we made it work was that I remember now. We kept on baiting it into doing that attack. Ow. Kept on baiting it into doing that attack. And then poking at it. There's so many allies. They are completely useless for anything other than being damage punches. There. Dead. We're already dead. And when I'm on the pause menu, we're dead. I don't know what to tell you. I quite honestly think it might not be possible to complete this encounter. I think one of our key issues here is that both squad mates that we have an ability in which an ability that has them charge straight into the enemy. Which against this specific enemy means that they are going to die extremely quickly whenever it uses the red explodey thing from point blank range. So we cannot regularly keep our squad mates alive. How much of a factor is that? It's not so, I mean, yes, obviously they're dealing some damage. The bigger thing is that there are 10 enemies here, thereabouts, because this guy spawns enemies repeatedly. And if we do not have squad mates, every single one of them is attacking us, and we die extremely quickly when that happens. So we at least need them to take fire off of us. So I honestly have no idea. No idea how we could possibly complete this encounter. It flat out looks impossible, at least with this group. At least with this group. If we had people who were tankier and who would not just run straight into this guy. Hold on. Is there a missile consumable that we just didn't bring here? I thought I vaguely remember that being the case. I can... Cannon should be doing this for. Oh, we didn't confirm... Didn't confirm us whether these would do anything for us. So, I mean... Part of me feels like... It can't be a coincidence. Oops. Can't be a coincidence that this is here. Ow, this is what I mean. Look at this, like... I need to cloak, otherwise we are gonna die almost instantaneously to the non-stop barrage of damage. Where is she? Like, it's not... In case you can't tell, it's not enjoyable either. Some places like that where we can store health and shields. Look at this. We just revived Korra seconds ago. She's already dead. She's already dead. Just teleport? I really am. So close. So close. I don't even know what the solution is, because I don't know how we get out of here. I honestly don't even know what we can do. Far and away the most difficult encounter. I mean, I want to kite these guys over here. I can't even kite them through the purple flames. Because of how quickly we go down and how quickly our squad mates go down, it's impossible for us to do so. It is impossible for us to do so. And the- We were cloaked! What on earth? It's actually impossible. Non-stop spamming the packs to restore our shields. Non-stop using cloaks so that we can at least have brief moments in which our enemies are not hitting us. Our allies go down so quickly that we have to run directly from one ally to another to keep them up. Can't even kite the enemy through the purple flames because we die before we can do so. It's impossible. Without either bailing and coming back on a later occasion with different squad mates, and maybe us being stronger, or just wimping out and lowering the difficulty. Because this is ridiculous. It's not fun. I hate it. Because there's no solution here. The only solution is if we get lucky and find a way to actually kite the guy through the purple fire, which I'm hoping...
Destroyer, stay alert!
...kills it almost instantaneously. Because that's just about the only way we could ever make this work. So here's what I'm gonna do. I'm not cloaking. I'm deliberately not cloaking. I'm trying to kite you here. So we need to be uncloaked to kite, right? So I'm going to stay covered here as long as I possibly can. While this is happening, more enemies are going to spawn, and they're going to flank us more effectively. Big enemy also has not engaged. This is probably going to backfire, sending our squad mates to go attack the big guy, because now that's the thing that keeps on killing them. I'm honestly surprised they didn't attack us earlier, but... What? Oh. Okay, I didn't even know those guys were there. Okay, I guess maybe by sending our squad mates after the big baddie that helped it remain stationary? Like, this was our attempt to kite him. Now, we are the only one alive, which in some ways might be a good thing for kiting purposes. Obviously, it's not a good thing from avoiding these guys. You are fast when you want to be. Here, I was thinking you were extremely slow. Look at this. Look at how many laser beams are firing at us right now. Look at how many laser beams are firing at us right now. And tell me how we are supposed to succeed here. And tell me how we are supposed to succeed here. Lids, don't let that many enemies spawn. Okay. The thing that's spawning those enemies is the enemy that we can only deal tiny little slivers of damage to. I do not see a way out of this without either leaving or lowering the difficulty. The difficulty spike. Astronomical. And it's, I would think that the purple flames are supposed to be there. Supposed to be there and all prominent and all that to be a sign, hey, this is the way to use the environment to damage the enemy. We just tried to stop the enemy or deal extra damage to the enemy using that strategy. It just doesn't work. So, honestly, I'm so frustrated with that I'm about to just turn this down to the lowest difficulty and just waltz on through this encounter because I hate it. And I'm at the point where I no longer care about that. Once upon a time, I would say, you know, no, we're going to try to power through. No. If I could find what category that is under. I mean, we might need to be in game. I would have thought that'd be under gameplay. What the heck? What the heck? Alright, we're gonna resume. I assume that it's on that pause menu. I'm going to lower it down to the lowest difficulty and just annihilate this thing and walk away. Because I'm extremely frustrated with it. And I think, to a certain extent, we did notice that this planet did seem to be the hardest one that we've encountered thus far. And this is definitely, far and away, the hardest encounter on this planet. Yes, we're right here. Okay, so can we... here... yes. Yeah, we were on a lower difficulty before. Honestly, I don't care. Once upon a time, I cared. For this, we'll turn it back up after this encounter. Or maybe, alright. Lower it one difficulty setting. Now we're overreacting, sure. We're on hardcore, let's go normal. Reason for that just being, can we determine? Can you see us when we're cloaked? When you do that? No?
Hostiles ahead.
I just want to see. Can we confirm as to whether, it's like, it's still probably going to be really hard. Can we confirm as to whether going over here deals significant damage to you? I just want to experiment with the kiting. I just want to know. is the secret to cutting. So, I mean, it certainly looks like that should be the case. That's obviously not the case. But he just doesn't move. Like, okay. Give me... Here you are trying to design this encounter with a powerful boss. An environment that you're supposed to use to take on that boss. Except the boss... doesn't make it possible to engage in that way. So it's meaningless. That is also not what I meant to do. That is the opposite of what I meant to do. Last time we fought this kind of enemy, it was in an encounter that I swear could not have this many additional enemies along with it. But does that do anything when he's held like or shielded like that? I don't think it does. The way that we eventually made it work was we did get him out into the middle like this. Can we cut you over here? Because I want to. Thus far, to get falling off the edge while we're at it. At least it doesn't immediately kill us. Just trying not to cloak because I want to get this guy in the area. Let's get closer to the other one now. Okay, he's very close. Nah, was close to this one. Not, I mean, we saw he can move kind of quickly when he wants to. But only very, very rarely. And so it is very difficult to move this guy anywhere. Okay, we're gonna fall off the edge again while we're at it. So bad. Where is it? It's over here. Okay, it's close. Cloak is expiring. Get you over here. And I cloaked. Okay, he's over here. No, hold on. Well, I'm inside that. Don't do that. Well, we need to do this again. I cannot get this guy to stand here. I cannot get him to stand here. Like, I know I have to keep on repositioning to revive squad mates, but... Is there a consumable that is a missile? If so, I would like to come back down here with a missile instead. Partly to make this easier, and partly for the catharsis. Just look at this. It is insufferable. what it's worth, it has also taken basically no damage. It's also taken basically no damage. Also, we are about to die again. Let's do a quick check here. So it might regenerate shields if it has not taken damage for a while. I wouldn't necessarily rule that out. Okay, this was mostly a test to see, on a lower difficulty, could we get it so that this thing would be more easily kiteable into the purple flames. It is not. We are reloading a save. We are lowering this to the lowest possible difficulty. We are going to shoot this thing in the face. It's going to explode, and we are going to call it a day, because this is ridiculous. I mean, technically, I would like to reload the save first, because we blew through basically all of our shields. All of our shield boosters. Okay, now we'll do it. Oh, whoops. Yes. See if we can tell the difference now. I certainly hope so. So I think on some level, this is supposed to be an encounter that you do very late on in the game. It is supposed to be really challenging. Okay, now this is a lot easier. As I would hope it would be. This is Flamer on shield, which is not supposed to deal a lot of damage. Yup. And I never want to see you again. Not in this encounter, at least. Alright, now it's dead. We'll turn it back on. Turn it back up to the usual difficulty. Not sure what I'm supposed to be looking at here, to be honest. Besides the purple flames. Oh, I actually did get pyramid tech for that? Yeah. Surprise, or pyramid intel. Okay. So, honestly, it's not that I'm against hard encounters. It's that I'm against humongous difficulty spikes that come out of nowhere. And that was unlike any encounter we've had before. We've only faced one of these guys once or twice before.
That must be the console to start the tilt.
And for some reason, this one, exponentially more difficult. As I said, may very well have had something to do with how we picked among the worst possible squadmates for this. The only other thing that might have been worse would have been if we had taken Jahl, because he also has an ability to put some right next to enemies. But there's that. There's the fact that it seems like you are supposed to use these purple flames. And as we said, it is next to impossible to do that. Doesn't matter what difficulty you put it on, that guy does not want to go over there. Might not have had something to do with how we had to run around reviving our squadmates? To a certain extent, yes. But there were times when we deliberately stood completely still, hiding behind one of those purple things waiting for the enemy to come over there, and they didn't. So, in that way, it feels like it was not just a humongous difficulty spike coming out of nowhere, but also a poorly designed arena, poorly designed encounter. And that is why I am okay on that occasion with us saying, you know, enough is enough. Because that was ridiculous. Then we can do that. And that, which means we need this here. That there. Oh, I was not looking at the squares. I was only looking for vertically and horizontally. So this does not work. You need to switch. Does that work? It seems like it. This looks good. There's obviously only one thing we can put here, and it is... Ooh. It's you. Okay, we should be able to swap these, right? Oh, wait, what is this doing here? That's not even right. Ooh. Yeah, okay, no, this has to be that. This has to be that, which is fine, I think. That means you have to be this, yep, and you have to be that. Does that check out? The E's? Yep, E's look good. Boxy dudes look good. The J's look good. The F's look good, and I think that's everything.
We did it. Well, you did it.
Multiple mechanisms activating. The remnant tiller is online. Within years, helium-3 production will increase dramatically.
We need to run out of here.
Send Tan the good news. We have fuel. Let's get back to the surface.
Maybe not. That rises very high on the list of least favorite encounter, or least favorite experiences in Andromeda, and might even be at the very top now. It's, competing against the... it's very different in nature to the thing that it's competing most directly against, which would be the Contagion quest.
Looks like we need an observer for this.
I'm also not sure if we got all those things, but... Just get me out of here, man. Just get me out of here. Never want to see this place again. But how do we get out of here? There's a console in this area, right? Yeah. Hoping we can just open up all the ones that are in these middle sections and get a straight line back. Does kind of seem like it. So where we came in? Getting there. Yeah, still shaking my head. That one, it just felt like that was an idea that they had that was never play-tested. With the whole special, it seemed like it was supposed to be, special arena for a major boss fight, a relatively major boss fight. It did not work. Some of that, again, may have been to a certain extent on us from the squadmate selection, but, I mean, that's a factor, right? It shouldn't, squadmate selection, sure, may make things a little easier, a little more difficult. It should not make them completely impossible. I stand by the fact that was completely impossible.
Tiller?
The mechanisms are deep underground, so the effects are not visible. Within months, you'll begin to see a dramatic increase in helium-3 production.
Not bad for a planet we wrote off.
Okay, I suppose that's a
Tempest is a
minor victory then.
Not the best name, but it's good.
So what would be best?
Hey, complaining doesn't mean I want it to be my job.
It never does.
Magnesium is also common, right? Yeah, I mean, with titanium or Platinum would, of course, be the preference, but in general, whenever we see these zones, it's pretty unusual for the actual rare one to pop up. That's a pretty high bar. Now we're out of the zone anyway? Okay. We were saying we might want to fast travel to one of the board stations that was relatively close to a different forward station. So we could get that last one. That's... If that's just a loyalty mission, we aren't going to do that. Not now. That's for a later occasion. This forward station, which also is right next to the Tempest, not that we have to go to the Tempest to come back, but let's at least get the forward station that is seemingly almost right next to us, and we are facing it as well. I can see it. Might be across a chasm. Or at least across a crater. Boom. Oh, we could have gotten a lot farther than that. That was possibly the best spot we've seen thus far for doing that.
Mining zones have been added to your nav system, Pathfinder.
Yeah, for a place with low grav, it is not any easier to climb hills. Okay, mining zones have been added. There's one over there in that corner. Don't think that is of critical importance. Mostly just wanted to get this so we could fast travel to it. And get a tiny little bit of Andromeda initiative points, I guess. Let's head back to the Tempest. And I'd like to say never speak of this place again. But we know that we'll be here in the future for Vetra's mission at the very least. At least that most of the time, the loyalty missions we've... Or most of the time, he says, after having done precisely one loyalty mission... The one loyalty mission we've done thus far took us to at least an entirely different sub-area. So, let's get out of here.
Taking her up. Where to next, Pathfinder?
Yeah, so in a word,
hello?
Insufferable, to put it simply. But we'll put that behind us now.
Feeling all right? You were clinically dead for a few seconds. I didn't even know a Sam could do that.
Yeah, apparently our Sam can. Rather not make that a regular occurrence, though.
Our Sam's special.
Ah, your father's modifications. Worked out well, didn't they? Anyway, thank you, Sam, for saving Ryder's life.
You're welcome, Dr. Anwar.
I forgot she's a doctor as well, technically.
I should get back to things.
Not of the medical variety, but of a different variety. Okay, any emails from that? So that was a relatively major mission. Nope. Okay.
You have AVP outstanding, Pathfinder.
I do remember that. Let's see. Should have this ready to go. Oops. This ready to go. And we probably have some of these missions ready as well. Okay. Silver. Good. Gold. This one, I think, was only a 70% chance of success, if I remember correctly. But we got it, so that's good. And that was the team that we needed for this one. Yeah, 70% is as good as it gets. So that is not a topic area that anyone can specialize in with an item. So the generalists must be called upon. And for these ones, shouldn't really matter. These are just bronze. So take your pick. Okay. And I guess we can open up the small number of packs that we just got there. Even if that is very minor compared to what we usually see. Well, I mean, we still got a Crusader, and level 6 Crusader at that. So that is somewhat significant. As... let's see. That is now better than this. We can break you down. And probably the other Rieger is, as I said, potentially still a very good weapon, but doesn't seem as though that's terribly difficult for us to get those. And Revenant, we will definitely dump that. And so yeah, now it's possible for us to get Black Widow 6. We haven't yet, obviously, but we can still dump these, and this is the... we haven't tried... again, I don't think we're gonna be that thorough when it comes to testing out sniper rifles specifically. Then we'd have to sell our mods. But, should be... yeah, we're doing relatively okay on that front. What we should do, before I forget, though, is we should sell our salvage. So that is very easy to forget. And we... I don't think I've done that for quite some time, because that's a lot. Okay, oh, look at that. The vendor is selling a Black Widow 6. Wow, that's very good. Thought we saw Crusader 2 here previously was always the go-to, but so not only has the weapon type changed, the level certainly has as well, and it did not for a while, I didn't think. Alright, well, we're at it. If we can... now we can't get the... the shields? Shields back? Darn. I do like my shields. But yeah, is there a consumable for the missiles? Because if so, that's the other thing that we theoretically could have done in that previous experience. Oh.
Processing. Cellulolysis would be hugely inefficient. Are you still trying to figure out how to eat Helios Flora?
Oh, shoot. I was talking out loud again, wasn't I?
Maybe. Did you do it here? Or is this only weapons? No, there are no missiles. Okay. Or if there are any, we don't have them yet. Would seem odd if they exist and we don't have them. So... okay. Duly noted. I mean, that we did have disruptor ammo, so I mean, we could have tried throwing that on and seeing if that would help a bit, and it would have, theoretically, but enough to be an actual difference maker? I would argue probably not. Okay, so I don't know if that was significant enough for anyone to have a comment about it.
Tev Uni. A home on Vold. Sort of. Still feels good, though.
Okay.
We'll talk later.
Might have some catch-up to do with Liam, apparently.
I know it.
So, that was a while ago. We were last on Vold.
Ryder.
Yeah, that's more the response I'm expecting.
You probably have work to do. We can check.
Not much, in other words.
You know where to find me.
Okay. But, for whatever it's worth... there was some question as to whether, it was pretty clear that the outcasts on whatever the name of that place is, on H047C, that the outlaws there were going to use the Helium-3 to create a bomb and use that bomb, presumably in some way, shape, or form to damage either the Nexus itself or one of the initiative colonies. For that reason, it was a high priority that we at least shut those down. Technically, did we need to go into the vault in order to stop them from doing that? I'm not sure that we did. The vault was for us harnessing that Helium-3 for ourselves. But, I mean, there were no outlaws there in the vault, of course, so I don't know. Again, that kind of unclear. That line got a little bit blurred with the way that Ryder and co. were explaining it when we fought the last enemies at the actual outlaw outposts. But we have done that, which means now we have a different bomb that we need to prevent people from creating, which is going to be on Elodin. This. So I think that becomes our next highest priority, because that becomes the thing that seems like the most imminent threat at the moment. And then once we've done that, we may choose to go further with our exploration on Elodin, as that we've not done as much of that as we have on other planets. But we do, of course, still have the main quest mission to speak with the leaders of the Nexus, which in some ways feels like it's still a debrief from our previous missions, but on the other hand, it does have a totally different name, so it does also seem like it is going to be the start of a new set of main quest missions. So should we wait to start doing this until we're ready to do a whole bunch of these things in quick succession? I don't know. We'll figure it out. But alas. Alas. Painful as it may have been, I suppose that was still... Okay, maybe accomplishment is a strong word to describe lowering it down to the lowest difficulty. I guess it's... We did the other stuff before that. And I hope that we don't have to do that again. I think... I would like to believe we will not find ourselves in one of those situations again. Will we encounter that type of enemy again in the future? Yeah, probably. But hopefully we'll have more power on Ryder and better set of squad mates to go up against such an enemy. And maybe not such an open area with terrible cover and where we're supposed to use the environment to damage the enemy, but the enemy never goes into the environmental hazard anyway, so it doesn't matter. I don't know.